Here we go. They all roll out of turn number four this time. I see the one to go signal. It's an all Tennessee row number two, but row number one represented by the great state of Kentucky and Indiana. Clay City, Kentucky's Connor Mead on the front row alongside the son of the legendary modern day cowboy, John Gill. That is Remington Gill in 75 out of Mitchell, Indiana. Row number two, Kyle Courtney in 171 in the 32 of Greg Husky, both Knoxville natives. As they'll roll out of turn number four this time, top four going to go to the big dance for 25 laps. Just a little bit later, good start at the line. We're underway. Into turn number one and two, and Remington Gill will get the jump on the top. Down the back straightaway. Problems in turn one and two. Kyle Courtney gets sideways, and Anna Parkhurst took the front clip with her. Marty Callaway piles in car number seven and will go yellow in admission. As we roll out of turn number four, we're going back to green with Connor Mead and Remington Gill. It's a good one at the line, and we're underway. Down the front straightaway, Remington's got momentum into turn number one down the back straightaway. Here comes the season veteran Greg Husky down the back straightaway, and Anna Parkhurst will hold the final transfer. Nobby's going to look to get in the field as he'll battle side by side for fifth with Cameron Skinner. Down the front straightaway, lap one will go to Remington. He is the new day cowboy. Down the back straightaway, Remington Gill in 75, now side by side for the runner-up spot. Here comes Husky to the inside of Clay City, Kentucky's Connor Mead, and he'll clear him for second. Down the front straightaway, lap two. We'll go to Remington Gill. It is Husky now second. Mead is third. Anna Parkhurst still holds the fourth and final transfer. Down the back straightaway, Nobby trying to get a grip on this racetrack. Can't do it down the back straightaway. Side by side for seventh. Marty Callaway will take that from Rodney Weeks as we've got three in the books and seven laps to go. Now down the back straightaway, Remington Gill on the top side of the speedway. Greg Husky starting to eat into that lead as they go back into three and four. They both go to the bottom. Remington pushes up just a tad and maybe just another half a tenth. Ticked off for the 32 of Greg Husky. Knows this racetrack all too well, the veteran out of Knoxville. Many, many laps at the Atomic Speedway, Tazzle Speedway for Greg Husky. Used to be a tag team tandem in the limited late model division when he ran with his brother Dale. And of course, always ran 32. His brother Dale used to be 23. What a duo they used to be. Out of turn number four, looking to the low side of Remington Gill. Couldn't get it done. Back into turn number one. Remington pushes up the hill. Here comes Husky down the back straightaway. Ticking hard into turn number three and four. Down the front straightaway now. Greg Husky closing in ever so much closer. Anna Parkhurst starting to run down the one of Connor Mead as they go back into turn number one. It looks that everyone is on the bottom except for fifth and sixth. Down the back straightaway, Dustin Nobby trying something new on the high side. Down the back straightaway, trying to run in Cameron Skinner. And here comes Husky again looking to the inside of the 75 of Remington Gills. They'll go down the back straightaway. Into three. Out of turn number four. Top four going to go to the feature. White flag in the air. Final time around for Remington Gill. Had a bit of a rough speed weeks. Had multiple mechanical issues down in Florida. Coming back through looking for a big day here at 411. Out of turn number four. Down the front straightaway, checker flag in the air, and it's going to be the new day cowboy. Remington Gill in 75 will win. Consolation number one, Husky will go second. Third will go to Connor Mead. And fourth to the 23 of Anna Parkhurst is your four transfers. Cameron Skinner is fifth. Dustin Nobby sixth in nine in. Seventh will be Marty Callaway. Eighth, Rodney Weeks. And ninth is Dale Reed. So the top four transfers will get to the scales to make it. And shotgun on the field. It'll be Dandridge, Tennessee's Warren McMahon. We are coming to green this time. 10 laps of distance will take the top four to the feature to complete the field. It's Jim Couch. It's RJ on the front row out of turn number four. 10 laps to get it done at the line, and we're underway. What a start for The Chattanooga Flash into turn number one. Down the back straightaway, he'll take the lead. Jim Couch digging hard in the bottom. Problems for Cranford in turn number two, and the caution is out. But you got three more rows of hungry drivers looking to get in today's 25-lap feature out of turn number four. We're back underway. Trying it again into turn number one. Johnson with a good start again. On the top side, down the back straightaway, gets on the fuel, and he'll take the lead. Halfway down the back straightaway, Jim Couch still second in 41. Into three, out of four. Good side-by-side battle for third, and Tim Maupin's going to win that for the meantime. Adam Mitchell fourth in 50, back into one. Down the back straightaway, Kip Sawyer looking to make his feature in that brand new car. Sitting one spot out, looking in. A little bit of debris flies off of the 61 of Kenny Ford down the back straightaway. Believe it's just a piece of plastic. We should stay green. And the caution is out. And caution is out. Piece of debris, and it possibly is metal down the back straightaway that flew off the 61 of Kenny Ford. So we'll go 1-6-2-2. 349-1622, looking for 349-1316. Two laps in the books, eight laps to go for RJ out of turn number four. And they come back to the white line. We're back underway. Jim Couch got sideways, and here comes Tim Maupin. Into turn number one, they'll go. Down the back straightaway. Adam Mitchell to the inside. He's going to look for the podium position under Tim Maupin. Back into three. Out of four, Maupin's going to slide up the hill, and here comes Adam Mitchell side-by-side for third and fourth. The final two transfers, and here comes Kenny Ford. Down the back straightaway, he's got fifth away from the 44 of Sawyer. He's looking for a transfer. Into three and four, it's still RJ out front. And Tim Maupin will spin out of the transfer. Tim Maupin. Knoxville Police Department, Adam Mitchell in 50 up to third. Out of four, we're back underway. They'll go into one. RJ will take the middle. Jim Couch to the low road. Down the back straightaway, Adam Mitchell's even lower. Kenny Ford gets sideways down the back straightaway in the final transfer, and now they're going to dice it up. Here comes Seymour, Indiana's Mason Covey. Down the front straightaway, Covey, eighth to fifth. Here comes Mason Covey. Back into turn number one, he's digging on the bottom, looking for the transfer. Down the back straightaway. Here comes Warren McMahon. Where did he come from? Down the back straightaway into turn number three and four. Your top three still the same. Kenny Ford holding the final transfer, but he has got a slew of cars looking to take over the final transfer. Down the back straightaway, they'll go again. RJ starting to put some distance between him and himself. They'll go three wide down the back straightaway. Here comes Tim Maupin. Into three and out of four. Slides up the hill. Good racing in the back of the pack. Back into one. Mason Covey holds fifth for the meantime. Still side by side now. Kip Sawyer back to the bottom. Down the back straightaway. They went three wide again for a moment. Tim Maupin digging on the bottom. Out of four. Good race for sixth, seventh, and eighth. Sawyer from fifth straight back to eighth. Now as they continue to dice it up in the top side of the racetrack, both grooves just as equally fast as the other. White flag for RJ, one to go. Anything can happen. Tim Maupin's got a fast ride in that three. Unfortunately, he spun out of the transfer. Mason Covey on the top. They're three wide again, and that's going to cost Kip Sawyer. He's going to loop it out of turn number four. They'll come to the checkered. RJ will win con C2. Second will go to Couch. Third will go to Mitchell, and fourth to Kenny Ford. Mason Covey made a good run at it, but he'll come up one spot short in fifth. Fourth transfer will go to the 61 of Kenny Ford. Third to Adam Mitchell in 50. Second to Hamilton, Ohio's Jim Couch. And your winner of consolation number two, the Chattanooga Flash out of Chattanooga, Tennessee, the CVR house car. That is Ronnie Johnson. Wind it up and get ready to show them one to go at the line. We are feature racing in the 2017 edition of the Frostbuster. Kicking off 2017. What a great season it's going to be between 411 Motor Speedway, Volunteer Speedway, under the same management officially with the McCarter family. It's going to be a good one. It's Jason Manley and Corey Hedgecock, proven champions on the front row, looking for 1,500, 25 laps to get it done out of four. It is showtime in Seymour. Here we go. Into one and two. They'll race down the back straightaway. They'll go three wide for the lead down the back. Hedgecock will use the wall, bank it down the back straightaway. He's got the lead into three. Rusty Ballinger making quick work of Forrest Trent. Now he's going for second lap. One will go to Hedgecock. Now Forrest Trent back to the outside of Ballinger. They'll go back into turn number one. One lap is in the books. 24 to go. Single file now for the top four, side by side for fifth. It's Jesse Lowe and Josh the Jet Henry. Here comes Manley to the inside of Hedgecock. Slick racetrack. As they go back into turn number one, makes for good racing. Down the back straightaway. They'll go again. Drew Deaver got to be careful, almost got the wall. Combs got sideways. We got problems in one and two. Caution is out in one and two. James Cole loops the 18. Into the outside of Rusty Ballinger's. We go back to green out of turn number four. Back into turn number one and two. They'll go down the back straightaway. Hedgecock still with it. Manley will keep second. Down the back straightaway. Jesse Lowe up the middle, and it didn't work. Went three wide, got into the B double zero of Josh Henry. Had to get off the gas. Lap three to Hedgecock. Field run down. Second is Manley. Third, Ballinger. Fourth will be the 101 of Forrest Trent. Fifth is the B double zero of Josh Henry. Then it's Lowe. Now Wilson up to seventh. 11th to seventh for the 29 working the top side of the speedway. Four in the books now. It'll be 20 to go next time. By here comes Wilson to the bottom. Down in one and two. Inside of Jesse Lowe. Down the back straightaway. That's a battle for sixth. Keep an eye on Ronnie Johnson. Starting to work the top side of the speedway as well in the back of the pack. And he's starting to come through. Look at Wilson with a big move in turn number four. Down inside to one and two. He's got fifth. Here comes the Hidden Hollow Motorsports entry. Jason Wilson on the move to the top five from 11th in just five laps. Six in the books now, 19 to go. Henry battles back to the outside. He'll keep Wilson in six for the meantime. Three cars going for the fifth spot down the back straightaway. Good racing now. Manley to the inside of Hedgecock at a turn number four. Good race down the front straightaway. Back into one. Hedgecock says, I'll go to the bottom. Manley right behind him. They'll go down the back straightaway. Rusty Ballinger will watch it all unfold from third. Wilson now to fifth. Down the back straightaway. They're still side by side for that spot. Manley loses a couple of car lengths on Hedgecock. And Zach Shannon is slowed in turn two. He'll exit the speedway and be done for the day. Gotta wonder if these guys can get to lap traffic, if they're gonna make it.
He's ready for the main event.
As Corey Hedgecock continues to lead into turn number one and two. Manley now about three car lengths back. Then it's Ballinger. Forrest Trent setting a solid fourth. Wilson has made it to fifth, trying to run down the 101. Manley now starting to close in again on the 23 of Hedgecock. And don't look now. Ronnie Johnson has worked his way about halfway through the field on the top side as he battles with Christian Hanger. He's making up good ground on the top side. If you can keep it going, the top side seems to be the way to go. Don't look now, but as they go into turn number one, they're going to enter lap traffic for the first time today. It's Hedgecock and the 32 of Manley. Down the back straightaway. They'll take the top road. Adam Mitchell, not having the greatest day, he'll take the bottom side by side for the lead at a turn number four. It'll be half a car at the line for Corey Hedgecock. Good battle for the lead. Manley's got a good piece. Down the back straightaway as they battle into lap traffic. Jim Couch in the top side of the speedway. That will affect this race as they go back into turn number one. Now Couch goes back to the bottom. Hedgecock to the bottom. Manley through the middle. Down the back. Manley's going to have a little momentum. Ballinger starting to close in now in 29 as well. Fourth is still Forrest Trent, and it's still Wilson in fifth. Out of four. They'll continue down the front straightaway, and Jim Couch closes off on the 23 of Hedgecock. Here comes Manley again. Corey to the inside of the Hamilton, Ohio veteran down the back straightaway into turn number three. He'll get by Manley to the inside now as well. And it's one lap car that will separate your leaders down the front straightaway. And now Corey Hedgecock will enter heavy lap traffic. 15 laps in the books, 10 laps to go for Corey Hedgecock. As they'll come into turn number four, heavy lap traffic, and here comes Ballinger. Where did he come from? He's on Manley's left rear quarter panel as they go into turn number one. The top three under a blanket for the lead. Nine and laps to go now for Corey Hedgecock as they'll roll down the back straightaway into three. And it'll be eight laps to go down the front straightaway this time as they get by Drew Devers, 12. They'll go back into turn number one. Down the back straightaway, Manley's going to get by with ease. Ballinger working as well. Wilson starting to reel in. Forrest Trent for the fourth spot. Into three. Out of four. Seven laps to go for Corey Hedgecock as he works to the outside of Anna Parkhurst into one and two. Rusty Ballinger still right there as well. Your top three separated by just a few car lengths as Robert J has called it quits. The five car goes to the infield. The CDR house car is done for the day. Still in heavy lap traffic is Corey Hedgecock and Jason Manley right together down the back straightaway. Just coming to five to go. And hard crash in turn one. It's Josh Henry in the wall. Josh Henry has killed the race car. Josh Henry has hit the wall hard in turn number one. Tough break, running, I believe, sixth at the time. Lesson to go for Corey Hedgecock. Can he get it done from the pole out of turn number four? Excuse me, outside pole. Back into turn number one they'll go. Ballinger going to put a move on Manley. Down the back straightaway, can't get it done. Manley will keep second. Ballinger third. Trent fourth. And it'll be the 29 of Wilson fifth. Out of turn number four, five laps to go. Just a handful left for Corey Hedgecock. Manley back into one and two, running a good line. As he'll go down the back straightaway, trying to make up some ground on Hedgecock. Now, not the best restart for Jason Manley. Wilson battling hard for fifth with Jesse Lowe, and he'll lose that spot. And Manley will slip back. Problems for Michael Courtney, C11. He'll pull to the infield and call it quits for the day. Turn number four, still Corey Hedgecock up front. Manley trying to run him down some way, somehow. Rusty Ballinger third. Fourth is Forrest Trent. And fifth now, Jesse Lowe over Wilson. Out of turn number four. Two laps to go for Corey Hedgecock. He will see the white rag next time we come by the flag stand. Down the back straightaway, he's got about eight car lengths on Jason Manley as they're going to turn number three and four. Veteran flagman, chief starter Mark Bells waves the white flag, one lap to go. Out of turn number four. Final time around for Corey Hedgecock. Rusty Ballinger will look down to the bottom side. Best race on the racetrack is for fifth. Out of turn number four, he's done it. The Loudon Lightning will go to victory lane, $1,500 for Corey Hedgecock. Second will go to Manley, third to Ballinger, fourth to Forrest Trent, and fifth to Jesse Lowe. And it'll be Wilson, Remington Gill, 17th to 7th, Chicky Barton, 8th. 9th will be Christian Hanger, and 10th to 5 of Mike Combs. So your hard charger, 17th to 7th for the 75 of Remington Gill. 5th will go to Jesse Lowe out of Crossville, Tennessee. 4th will be the Talbot Terror, Forrest Trent at 101. 3rd to Rusty Ballinger, 2nd to Jason Manley, and your winner. And look at him blowing smoke, overheating. Blowing a little steam of the 23. Your winner today in the Cray Lemon Oil portion of the Frostbuster. How about it for Corey Hedgecock? It's a distance. Kenny Ford and Warren McMahon on the front row out of turn number four. What do you see? Green, green, green. We're underway. Into one and two, Kenny Ford will lead them down the back straightaway. Warren McMahon second, Skinner third. They almost went three wide for third, and now Kyle Courtney will go to third and 171. Second place at the crate late model portion of the Cabin Fever event at Boyd's just a few weeks ago in January for Kyle Courtney after he set fast time. Just got edged by Corey Hedgecock and did make the field today And try to come from the back of the non-qualifier to get the win. Two laps will go on the board right here for Kenny. 4-8 laps to go. We're in Matt Mahan third. Second. Now here comes Kyle Courtney, the third place runner, looking for second down the back straightaway. Fourth is Nobby. Fifth is Cameron Skinner and Dale Reed back in sixth. Back down the back straightaway they go. Kyle Courtney now continues to battle with Andrews Tennessee's Warren Matt Mahan, a former Crately Model champion at Volunteer Speedway, where we will be next week, March the 4th. With McCarter Promotions down the back straightaway again. Kyle Courtney continues to work under him. Down the back straightaway, Kenny Ford has said, see you later. He's checking out down the front straightaway now, as the laps wind down in this one, just a 10-lapper. Kyle Courtney continued to work over the 33 of Warren Matt Mahan for second as they go down the back straightaway. But it's all Kenny Ford up front in the 61 car. Down the front straightaway now. Nobby still is running fourth. He got by Skinner. As they go back into turn number one, and Dustin Nobby may have figured something out as they go down the back straightaway. Starting to close in on second and third. Final laps here for Kenny Ford. Warren Matt Mahan still second. Third, Kyle Courtney on the bottom. Nobby watching it all unfold in the battle for second. Out of turn number two. Out of turn number four now, Kenny Ford. To the line, two laps to go for Kenny Ford in 61. Still a good race for second. That's where it's at. Kyle Courtney back to the bottom. Out of turn number two, side by side down the back straightaway for second. Now here comes Nobby into turn number three and four for third. White flag for Kenny Ford. Good battle. Here comes Nobby for second. Down the front straightaway to the inside of Warren Matt Mahan. Good race. Dustin Nobby going to second by Warren Matt Mahan. Good race out of turn number four, checkered flag. It'll be Kenny Ford getting the win. Second out of turn number four from the tail, it'll be Dustin Nobby in nine. Third will go to Warren Matt Mahan. Fourth to Kyle Courtney. And fifth to Cameron Skinner. How about that run for Dustin Nobby to second? But your winner of the non-qualifier race, it'll be Kenny Ford in 61. And that will wrap us up at 411 today. Folks, we thank you so much for coming out. Don't forget, final reminder, next Saturday we will be at Volunteer Speedway for the first event of the McCarter era, taking over in Bulls Gap. And $5 grandstand admission. Make sure you are there. It's going to be a good show. And until then, we thank you for kicking off the 2017 season with us at the Frostbuster 40. Until then, so long, and we will see you down the road at the race.